everyone. In the last class, we discussed about one of the experimental method called cryo-electron microscopy. So in today's class, we'll be discussing about computational method to predict the protein structure prediction, that is homology modeling. Before going to the introduction of homology modeling, we'll just look at the flow chart or workflow for the experimental methods. So for doing experimental method, we have to get the protein of interest or gene of interest, and we have to create cDNA library, or we have to extract cDNA and then we have to insert in an expression system. After inserting cDNA into expression system, then we have to grow the cDNA into the culture vessel, and then we have to purify the protein by the chromatographic technique so that we can go for the NMR spectroscopy, or we can crystalline the protein and then we can go for X-ray crystallography, or we can preserve the protein or process the protein at cryogenic temperature so that we can go for cryo-electron microscopy. After doing any one of the analysis, we'll get the data analysis for the particular protein, by which that we'll get the final protein structure by experimental method. This is how experimental method will be done. Now we'll be discussing about the computational method, homology modeling. Homology modeling is one of the computational method to predict the protein structure. It's also known as comparative modeling of protein structure prediction. Here we'll construct the unknown protein structure by using the template protein structure. The template protein structure will be getting from the any one of the protein database sequences, or will be getting from the any one of the protein databases. So here we'll compare our target protein with our template protein by sequence similarity. So if our sequence similarity is equal to or greater than 30%, then we can able to perform homology modeling. If not, we have to choose any other method of computational prediction. Now we'll be discussing about the workflow for homology modeling. So initially we'll find or identify the template sequences or template structure. By comparing them, we'll get the best template structure. And then we'll compare our target protein or target sequence with template structure. And then we will create a model. If the model is good, then we'll get the perfect 3D protein structure. If not, we have to again trace back to get the best template again, and we have to process the same. There are about 7 steps to perform homology modeling. They are initial alignment and template recognition, alignment correction, backbone generation, sidechain modeling, loop modeling, model optimization, and model validation. We'll be discussing about each steps in detail. The first step is template recognition and initial alignment. In this step, we'll be searching PDB databases for homologous protein with determined structures. So in this step, we'll be performing sequence alignment by using the programs like BLAST or FASTA for determining the percentage identity for target and template sequences. And also to get the hits of sequences, we'll be using scoring matrices like residual exchange matrix and alignment matrix will be used for comparing the query sequences with all known possible PDB sequences in the database. The second step is alignment correction. So in this step, there are some possibilities that our template sequences will not be comparing or will not be identical with the other sequence when we align two or more sequences. In that case, we have to choose the correct sequences by percentage identity. So for example, in the picture, you're able to see template sequence and two model sequence. The template sequence is not perfectly aligned or identical with the model 1 sequence. But then the template sequences is identical, or the percentage identity is higher when compared to the model 1 sequence. So we can say the template sequence is comparing with the model 1 sequence. So this is how alignment correction will be done in homology modeling. So now the third step is backbone generation. When the alignment correction is perfect and alignment is good, then we have to do the backbone generation, or we have to create a backbone residues for the target sequence. So the coordinates of the template sequence are copied to the target sequence. In some cases, the residue of the template sequences will be same like target sequence, so that we can copy those residue to the target sequence too. For example, if the amino acid proline is present in the 12th position of the template sequence and it's also present in the 12th position of the target sequence, then the residue can be copied directly to the target sequence by comparing with the template sequence. This is known as backbone generation. The fourth step is loop modeling. After sequence alignment, there are often regions like insertion and deletion can lead to gap formation. This gap formation has to be modeled with help of the process called loop modeling. There are two main methods to perform loop modeling. They are database searching method and then ab initio method. In database searching method, it involves searching the loops from the known protein structure and it will superimpose on the target protein sequences. And mostly specialized programs like Coda will be used for this method. Another one is ab initio method. In ab initio method, it will generate random loops and will choose the best loop by comparing the lowest energy value. So the loop with lowest energy value will be taken for the purpose, and also it will look for the pi and psi angle values with respect to the Ramachandran plot. The fifth step is sidechain modeling. In this method, it will evaluate or estimate the protein-ligand interaction at active site and also protein-protein interaction at contact interfaces. So the sidechains will be generated with the help of the conformational changes or angles of the Tarsen angle of the sidechains, and the best Tarsen angle with lowest interactive energy with the neighboring actum will be taken into consideration. Here, Rotamer library will be used to get the sidechain for our target protein sequence by comparing the known protein sequences. The next step is model optimization. Here, energy minimization will be done so that overall structure of the protein will be of lower energy value. And also, the goal is to get the steric collision or to release the steric collision without altering the structure. So, the model optimization can be done with the help of molecular dynamic simulation, where the atoms will be tend to move to the global minima by considering conditions like heating and cooling, which tend to get the true structure of the protein. The energy bonding considered here are stretching energy, bending energy, Tarsen angle energy, and non-bonding interactive energy. The last and final step in homology modeling is model validation. So every model tend to have errors. There are two main reasons for that. So the first one is the percentage identity between template and target sequence. If the percentage identity is greater than 90%, then the model can be compared with the crystallographic tetramine structure. And if in case the percentage identity is less than 30%, it'll tend to have some errors. The second main reason is the number of errors in template. These are the two main major reasons for errors in homology modeling. And then the final model has to be evaluated for pi and psi angle, chirality, bond length, close contact, and other stereochemical properties. And also the tools like Modeler, Swiss Model, Schrodinger, and 3D Jigsaw were some of the modeler programs which can be used for performing homology modeling. The successful model depends on the template selection, algorithm used, and also model validation. Now we'll be discussing about the advantages of the homology modeling. Homology modeling helps us to find the location of the alpha chain in the folded proteins, and also it is used to study about the mutagenistic experiment, and also it helps us to find the structure and function relationship. And homology modeling helps us to find the active sites and loops and side chains in the conserved region of the protein. Finally, we'll be looking at the disadvantages of the homology modeling. The disadvantages of the homology modeling is that it will be unable to predict the conformation of the insertion, deletion, or side chain positioning at a higher accuracy. And then another biggest disadvantage is that it will not be useful for modeling or ligand docking studies, especially for drug designing and development. If in case the template and target identity is greater than 70%, then it can be used for the same. We came to the end of this session. Hope you all understand about homology modeling. In today's session, we discussed about one of the computational methods to predict protein structure is called homology modeling. And then in next session, we'll be discussing about fold recognition and ab initio method. Thank you all.